Well, hello guys. Sorry I haven't uploaded for a video for all these days, but today I want to make an experiment. What the experiment will be basically is that I will talk about how my life is now and how I'm feeling, and then in 3 months exactly, I will make a video response to this talking about exactly the same thing. And I will call this experiment the time capsule. So now I'm going to talk about a few things about myself that I'll want to keep note until next time. First of all, I'm 120 kilos. That's 264 pounds. That's a lot. But it's the thing that I'm most self-conscious about. I just can't get my mind off it. No matter what other people say, oh, it doesn't seem so, and all that kind of stuff. Well, the thing that matters to me is that it seems to me. What I want to do is I want to lose weight. Not just for the way I look towards the outside, what people think about me. I just want to do it for the health aspect of the whole thing. You know, I want to feel light and fit, right? So I do want to lose that weight. I have to. And I hope by the end of summer, I will have reached my ideal. Second, I haven't practiced guitar properly. Well, what I mean properly is like 3 hours and up a day for about a month. Like, how can I explain this? I've basically put a program to myself to at least do 3 to 5 hours of guitar practice a day, and I would write down what I did in detail into a book, and I'll count how many hours I've done in a month and a week and all that kind of stuff. So I haven't done that for a month. I've just totally slacked off. I really want to fix that. Three, I make zero income. Basically, it's logical. I'm a student, but I do want to have an income. I want to make some money. Who doesn't? Let's be honest. But the reason why is that I want to be able to buy things. For example, musical instruments, equipment, video cameras, and not, you know, just be a leech off my parents and take all their money, and they don't even have enough money for themselves. Four, I'm emotionally unstable. Basically, I don't know, that's probably not a good way to say it, but I just can never stay in one phase. Like one day I might be happy, the next day I might be sad, and then just goes up and down. So I can't just like stay motivated. I might be like really, yeah, let's go for it, you know, power. And then like half an hour later, I'm like, oh, fuck it, you know. And then I just jump back and forth, and I never really get anything done. It's like procrastination at some point. So I really want to get through with that. I just want to be full on power. Five. I'm a stress bomb. Screw that. I have so many worries in my head, especially now that I'm looking at a transitional period that I have to prepare myself for college and I have to leave and then it accumulates with the other stuff like weight and money and all this kind of stuff, and I just put it in my head all at the same time and I just overload. I just have a nervous breakdown. Six. Well, this isn't negative, but it's a beginning, so I want to see if I actually keep this for 3 months. Today, I began a vegetarian lifestyle. This is big, seriously. I've been a meat eater extraordinaire. So basically, I just came to the thought and understood the impact of meat eating and how negative it is, and the slaughter of innocent animals and what conditions they live in, what they feed them, and what goes into our bodies. It's just bad. So I really want to like reduce my meat consumption to an ultimate minimum. I'm really curious to see how this is going to last, for how long. Well, I'm really hoping that it lasts. Seven. This is a weird one. My room is a mess. It's complete shambles. Nothing is in its place. I might like clean it one day, and the next day it's totally crap. Just totally, nothing's in its place. Everything's upside down. Things get thrown over there, then we get thrown over here. Whatever. Eight. This is more of a environment issue. Basically, what I wrote is that I live in a negative family home environment. So what I want to mean by that is that basically the house that I'm in isn't very optimistic. It's always in stress. It's depressed, stressful. It just brings you down. Like, you might be motivated to do something in the day, like you see something cool outside, you're like, I'm gonna run home and just put everything down, set it up and fix it. I make all these big plans, like I fill up books full, you know, textbooks full of ideas and thoughts and plans, but when I get home, I just walk in and everything just looks depressed and down and negative. So I just, it brings me down. I just get affected by it immediately. So I'm hoping that in 3 months, they'll be gone. That'll be amazing if that happens. Like, if that fixes, everything else will bloom. Everything else will work its way. Now, you may ask me, why did I do this? Well, the reason why I did this is so I can have, so I can basically give out to everybody, including myself, proof and a document, let's say, of how I was and how I felt. So I can be able to compare that in the future. For example, in 3 months, and then maybe in 6 months, and going on and on. Because I'm trying to actually keep this thing going. I want to keep the time capsule for a few years. And if it's going successfully, even more. This might all sound so dooming and negative and all this kind of stuff, but actually the core reason of this is basically optimistic. I basically did this because I knew that in 3 months' time, and even more, that my life will be a lot better. So I basically am making this video so I can motivate myself to improve my life, so I can look back and say, I'm having such a better time, I've fixed this, 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 and this. What I want you to do is to either comment, or even better, like this is the best, to video response, telling me what would your time capsule be. What would you want to change in 3 months? Also, don't forget to like this video, post in your favorites, share it to other people that you'll want to send this message to. Also, don't forget to subscribe, either to the development of the time capsule or to check out my latest videos. The latest videos are going to come out, are going to be awesome. I've written down a couple and there's going to be a lot more to come. So basically, my routine got a bit cut because I really wanted to make this experiment, but from now on it's just going to be full on awesome, okay? So I really appreciate that you actually watched this video all the way this far. I thank you for listening, hope to see your feedback, and I will see you next time. So until next time, light.